Hi guys, this is that techie dude back again talking about the smart TV experience that I'm enjoying and having fun with. As I promised in my last post, the first post after that would be introduction to my TV. And so I will present to you the TV that I currently own and I recently bought. This is the Toshiba 39L4300. 39 is the size of the TV. And L4300 is Toshiba's name for their Android smart TV series. And this smart TV uses Android 4.2 operating system. Apart from that, the basic specs in terms of hardware are, it has three USB slots. One of the advantages of this TV is that it comes with a Wi-Fi dongle that you can put into the slot, into the USB slot. And now I've also connected one of the slots to my Logitech keyboard and mouse combo. So I've used up two of my three USB slots. This TV comes with two HDMI connections. I'm using one to play Skyfall, which is one of my favorite movies. Skyfall is a beautiful movie to watch on TV, and it gives you a good idea about picture quality because it has lots of shades of gray. And bright colors like are easy to reproduce, but the real test of picture quality is when you see colors and shades and pastels and shades of gray. So that's why Skyfall is a favorite movie of mine, and I'm going to use it to test this TV's picture quality. Not test it actually, I've already tested it before I bought it, but to show it to you. Apart from this, I just want to go to the main screen of the TV. As I said, I've connected this TV to a Logitech keyboard mouse combo. Pressing the right mouse click twice takes me to the TV's home screen. Now, this is pretty similar to what you see on an Android smartphone in the sense that you have this center part, which is the key hard-coded apps or widgets. You have this as the this page is the home screen. And what is playing on the TV through the Blu-ray is shown here. The moment you want to go to full screen, you just press this full screen and it goes to a full screen. You press the right mouse click again and it comes back to the main home page. As you can see, the most popular applications that you're likely to use are already hard-coded. If you have photographs, if you have music, videos, if you want to go to the Play Store, the browser, if you want to go to YouTube or check anything about the music or the screen mirroring connection with your smartphone, everything is here on the first page itself. That's quite easy to use your shortcuts, your main shortcuts on page one. Of course, you have plenty of space for customizing it. For example, my wife's data is going to be here. Her favorite apps and widgets are going to be here. And mine are going to be here. So I can kind of customize each home page for example, what kind of shortcuts or apps that I want to do. And coming back to the main screen, as you can see on top, it says today's date, which is the 30th of April, Wednesday. The timing is wrong because I haven't set up the TV right now. So the TV just says username blank owner. This is the settings shortcut. This is again a browser shortcut, the same as this. This is the list of all the apps and widgets that are installed on the TV. You can add more from the Play Store. And this is the basic introduction to the TV, which I just wanted to share with you before we go to the next post. The next post is